Hi student, welcome back to schoolquiz.com. And as we discussed before, we started the chapters there, the quality questions, and I get some topics also, means how to find the roots of quality questions by prime factorization method or similar to the split method, and completing square method and formula method also. So today we will see the sum of roots and the product of roots, means how we are getting the formula there. So see, as we discussed in the last video, means the formula of that equation x equals to minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a variable. So if I am saying, if it is alpha equals to, means one root is will be minus b plus b square minus 4ac by 2a, and another root beta equals to minus b plus suppose minus b square minus 4ac by 2a. So how we can derive that sum of roots, means if I do alpha plus beta here, means adding the roots there, so minus b by 2a plus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a for alpha, and plus beta we can write it as minus b by 2a minus b square minus 4ac by 4bci 2a. So this is nothing but alpha and this is nothing but beta. So if I see minus b by 2a, minus b by 2a, so I can write minus 2b by 2a because twice of terms are there, plus b square by 2a minus b square, so I can cancel this one. So what I am getting here, so if I am adding the root, I am getting minus b by a. So sum of root we are getting minus b by a here. Okay, so now see the another one, how we can find the product of roots, means I am adding alpha into beta here. So alpha is nothing but minus b by 2a plus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a, and into beta will be minus b by 2a minus b square minus 4ac by 2a. So by seeing this, I am getting here a plus b, a minus b. So this is nothing but a square minus b square. So a square minus b square minus 4ac by 2a ka whole square. So what, b square by 4a square minus, if I am doing the square of this number, then this will be b square minus 4ac by 2a is nothing but 4a square. This is also 4a square I am getting. So minus b plus b square by 4a square minus b square by 4a square. See what I am doing here, if I do the square of this number, square of this number, this is square root will be go off. So b square minus 4ac is as it is. So now if I multiply this minus, this will become plus here. So b square, this 2a square will be square, means 4a square. So that will divide by this number also, this number also. Now this is square root is over because of this is square. Now so b square by 4a square, b square by 4a square, that opposite sign is there, that will be cancelled out. And what is left here? 4 cancel, 1a is cancelled. So some product of root I am getting c by a simply here. So by using the formula method only we can introduce, means the relationship between roots and that coefficient of that quadratic questions there. So product of root is nothing but minus b by a, and the product of root equals to c by a. So we will see means how we can manage in the formula there. But see, so we know standard form ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. So if I divide by a both side, divide by a both side means divide by a both side, then x square plus b by a x plus c by a equals to 0. Now see this b by a and c by a I am getting in that equations. So can I manage like an x square if I kept this minus b by a? Okay, x plus c by a equals to 0. Now this is look like the sum of root and this is look like the product of both. So can I arrange like that only? So if I am saying x square minus sum of root of x plus product of roots equals to 0. So we can manage our quadratic questions in this form also. If coefficient of x square is 1, then I can easily write. If it is not 1 also, we can carry it as means divide by that particular numbers what is there with the x square, and we can easily in the form of sum of root and the product of root of your quadratic question. So see, quadratic question is very easy chapters, means you can easily deduce the things there. So see, if I say the last question, suppose for the x square plus 4x minus 5 equals to 0, then from there we can I write like minus 4 of x minus 5 equals to 0, means sum of root is nothing but minus 4 and product of root is nothing but minus 5. So from there also we can easily deduce the sum of roots and the product of roots, or if they mention the question in the form of sum of root and product of root, then you can easily find the quadratic question also. So we will check one questions by this method. Suppose they mention you as a sum of root alpha plus beta equals to 5 and alpha into beta is suppose 6. Then how you can reduce the quadratic equations? As we know, x square minus sum of root of x plus product of root equals to 0. So sum of root, in place of sum of root, you can substitute there x square. So 5 of x plus 6 equals to 0. So x square minus 5x plus 6 equals to 0. So like that you can easily write the quadratic question if they mention it as a quadratic sum of root and the product of roots. So next lectures, basically I'll give you the description regarding the characteristics of roots, or we can say how the roots will vary according to the situations there. Okay, so we will discuss on that in the next lecture, nature of roots. Okay, so till then see those lectures and try to understand that, and if you are not getting any point, just write on us and we will discuss the more point on that. Okay, so thank you everyone, keep watching there. Okay, thank you.